Hey, what's up everyone? WordPress has its default post type, which is great for posting on a blog. But what if you want to add a different post type to your WordPress site? The first way we're going to create a custom post type on our website is by using a plugin called WPCode and then adding some custom code to that. Now I know what you're thinking, did he just say I'm going to add custom code to my website? What if I've never done it before and won't I break my website? Well, the great thing is that WPCode has been built with these questions in mind, is easy to use and comes with a whole library of tried and tested code snippets to help you open up the functionality of your WordPress site with no coding knowledge needed. Let's check it out. So to get started, all we need to do is install WPCode on our WordPress site. To do that, we just need to head over to plugins here on the left-hand side, hover over that and click on add new. Now we're on the add plugins page. We just come up here to the search bar on the top right, click on there and type in WPCode. This is WPCode right here. All we need to do is click on the install now button. That's going to install the plugin. And once the plugin's installed, that turns to an activate button. Just click on that. Now we can see WPCode is installed and activated on our website. So now let's take a look at WPCode. So we're going to come over to code snippets here on the left-hand side of the screen and click on that. So this is the main screen of the WPCode plugin. WPCode is a code snippets plugin, which allows you to add lots of different functionality to your WordPress site through adding little bits of custom code. To add custom post types to our site, all we need to do is head up to the add new button up here, click on that. And that brings us to the code snippet library. And there are lots of ready-made code snippets ready to use in this library that are tried and tested. I totally encourage you to check them out to see if there's something there that you'd be able to use on your website. For this video, we're going to add custom code to our website. So we're going to click on the add your custom code new snippet here. So that's opened up the custom code snippet editor. The first thing we need to do is add a title for our snippet. I'm going to call mine custom post type. When I've done that, I'm just going to click the toggle here to activate it, so that it'll be active once I save the snippet on this website. In the code preview section here, what we need to do is change the code type to PHP snippet, because that's what we're going to use for this custom code. I've linked to the blog article in the description below of this video. Click on that link and that'll bring up the article in a new tab, just like this. And this article then has the code snippets on them for you to copy across. So our first code snippet here is a more simplified version of a custom post type. So we're going to copy that across to our WPCode plugin. So now we're back in WordPress. Under the code preview section, we're just going to paste that code in. It's just telling us that we're going to create a custom post type right here. The post type that we're creating is a movies section to the website for us to be able to create posts under that heading. The options other than that, the label name that we're going to be using for this is movies, so we can change that to whatever we like. So if it was portfolio, photos, a different section to the website where you want separate posts, you just change that to whatever you want. Singular name is movie, and then underneath that a few different options. So do we want it to be a public post type, has an archive so that all the posts can be displayed on a page together? We're going to have that as true. And underneath that, there's a section here to choose the slug. So what shows up as in the URL. So it'll be our website /movies/ whatever the post is. And that's the simplified version of the post type. So we're just going to click save snippet to save those changes. And once we've saved that, we can see there's the movie section has shown up here on the left-hand side. If we click on that, we can now see that this is the movies section of the website and we can add new posts in there. If we go back to our code snippet, we can see that our custom post type snippet is right there on the screen and its status is toggled to on. We can disable it by toggling that as well if we want to. To edit it, we can click the edit link underneath the custom post type. And now let's add in the more in-depth custom code and have a look at that. We head back to the article, we scroll down slightly. This is the code we want right here. So we're just gonna grab that, copy that, head back to WordPress. We grab all this code and delete that and post in the new code. Just before we update it, we'll go through it a little bit. So this gives us a little bit more options about how it looks and we can change the different options for it. So using the movies theme, we can set the UI labels for the custom post type. So that's what we see up here in the on the left-hand side of the screen. So the name of that section is movies, change it to whatever we want. Singular name is movie, menu name up here is movies too. And then as you go down, you can change all these to whatever you want them to be. In this section here, we can change the label description of this custom post type. And then the features this custom post type supports in the post editor. So when we create a post underneath the movie section, this will then support these features when we're creating that post. With this custom post type, we'll get the option to add a title, choose the editor, add an excerpt, the author, add a thumbnail to it as well, allow comments, and then multiple custom fields if we create more custom fields as well. And here are a few more options that we can change to really customize this to what we need for our site. Once you're happy with that, click update. That's that snippet updated there. And as you can see, the movie's custom post type is there as well. And we can add as many of these to the website as we need. So if you've got different sections that you need different posts under, then I suggest using this method to add those in. Now in our second method, we're gonna add a plugin called Custom Post Type UI to our WordPress site. And that's a dedicated plugin for creating custom post types. Let's check it out. To add the custom post type UI to our website, we just need to install it. So we're going to go over to plugins here on the left hand side, hover over that and click on add new. Then in the search bar up here on the right, we're just going to write custom post type. This is the plugin we want right here, custom post type UI by Web Dev Studios. Click the install now button to install that plugin. Now that plugin's installed, click the activate button to activate it. And now we can see the plugin's been installed and activated on the website. Let's check it out. So here it is on the left-hand side of the screen, just click on CPT UI. And that brings us to add and edit post types. Diving straight in, the underneath the post types like here, we choose the name of what we want to see in the URL. We'll use movies as the example for this. Then we can choose the plural type label. So it's got movies, the singular type label. And once you've added those in, you can add the post type to the website. So once we've done that, we can see the movies section is on the website and we can add a post to it. And that'll be headed underneath that section. We go to the custom post type UI. So if we want to change the settings of our custom post type that we just created, go to edit post types. You can select the post type that you want. So we've just got movies, so we're going to select that. So underneath these basic settings here are the additional labels. So if we scroll down a little bit, we'll be able to take a look at them. So we can add in a post type description. So we can put into detail what this post type is used for. Then below that are options to change the different labels that you see across WordPress for this custom post type. So currently its menu name is movies at the moment, but we might want to change that to my movies. When we click on the movies section, we see an add new button, but we can change that to add new movie. We can also change any of the other labels below that as well. If we save that post type now, we can now see it's changed to my movies on this side. And if we hover over it, we can see we can add new movie, and that's to post a new movie to that section of the website. So below the additional labels section, we can now see the custom post type settings. So each one of these has a little bit of a description to let you know what each one does. Just to go over a couple, we can change whether this custom post type can be shown publicly on the website, and also whether it can be shown in the navigation menu. We scroll down a little bit. So we can choose the menu position, and we can also choose the dash icon that comes up by the post type. So we can change it to a media type dash icon, and if we save that, you can now see that's changed. Back to that section. And then just below that, in the support section, we can choose what features are supported in this post type. So at the moment, we've got the title, we've got the editor for it, and a featured image. We can also add in whether we've got any custom fields, so we can choose them. We can show the author, and also maybe an excerpt as well. So once you're happy with that, you just save the post type, and then your post type is ready to use, and you add posts to it. Now that we've created our custom post type, there are a few ways that we can display it on our site. We can add it to our site navigation, we can add it to the front page, and we can also use a widget to add it to the sidebar. I'm going to check each one of those out quickly now. Once you've created a couple of posts under your custom post type, then you'll probably want to display them on your website and make them easy for your users to find. To do that, what we're going to do is we're going to add our custom post type as a link to our navigation menu. To do that, first we need to check our permalink settings on our website. So head over to settings here on the left hand side, hover over that, and then click on permalinks. So what we're looking for is for our permalink structure to be under post name, and that makes it super easy to add it to our navigation menu. If you do have a different structure to your permalinks and it's a site that's been going for some time, you probably don't want to change this now because it could damage your SEO. But the post name permalink settings does have added benefits for SEO if you're starting a new site, so I would definitely recommend using that. Once you've chosen that, click save changes. Once we've done that, we can head to appearance, hover over that, and then click on menus. So now we're on the menu settings section of our website. We need to add this custom post type to the menu. So as you can see, we've got different pages on our menu. Underneath the add menu items here, we can choose any of the pages that we have. It's not a page that we're adding to it, we're going to add a custom link. So we're going to toggle that down. Now we need the URL for our custom link. So we're going to copy the website URL, paste that in, and then after the forward slash, you're just going to type in whatever your URL slug is that you chose for your custom post type. Mine was movies. And then underneath that, we can choose the link text. So the link text is something that's going to show up in the menu structure here. I'm going to choose movies. Then you're going to click add to menu. Now that's added it to our menu, and we can drag that to wherever we want it. Once we're happy with that, we can click save menu. So now if we head to our website and then we click on our movie section in the navigation menu, that will then bring up our movie archive for our custom post type. If you want to display your custom post type on the front page of your website, that's fairly straightforward too. All we need to do is head to code snippets. Once we're in WP code, we can click on add new, to add a new snippet to our website, add a new custom code, click on that, give the code snippet a title, toggle it to active, change this code type to PHP, and then use the link in the description below to go to the article link to this video. Once you're on the article, you want to head to the display custom post types on your site section, scroll down a little bit, and then under the display custom post types on the front page, you want to copy this code and then head back to WP code and add it to your code preview. You can leave all the other settings as they are and then just save the snippet. Now that snippet's been saved, if we go to the website, and there you can see your custom post type posts displayed on your website front page. If you want to display your custom post types with a widget in a sidebar or something like that, you can definitely do that too. And we can do that by installing the custom post type widgets plugin to our WordPress site. To do that, we're going to head to plugins, hover over that and click on add new. In the search bar up here, we're just going to write custom post type widgets. And this is the custom post type widgets here that we want to install. So we're going to install, click install now. Then we're just going to click the activate button to activate that. Now we can see that's activated on the website. So all we need to do now is go to appearance over here, hover over that, and then click on widgets. Now we're in the widget section of our website. We can see that we've got nothing in our main sidebar here. We can click on this add block button right there. In the search bar, we just want to search for custom post type. As you can see, it brings up a few different options. The one we want is right here, recent posts, custom post type. That's dropped that into our main sidebar here. We're just going to give this widget a name, recent movies. We're going to choose the post type to be movies, which is the custom post type we've just created. Number of posts to show, we'll just leave it as that, and we can choose to display the post date as well. So click update up here in the top right to save those changes. And if we head to our website, we should be able to see in the sidebar here, we can see the recent movies in our custom post type widget. So now you know how flexible and adaptable WordPress can be by adding custom post types to your website. WordPress actually has a lot of hidden functions that can't be accessed unless you add custom code to your site. That's why WP Code is so awesome, with its library of code snippets that are tried and tested for you to check out and use on your site. If you want to find out a little bit more about WP Code, check this video out next. Thanks for watching.